Today we will do one poem, No Men Are Foreign by James Kirkup. James Kirkup was one of the leading modern English poets. He grew up in South Shields and his first poetry book was The Drowned Sailor, which was published in 1947. He became a fellow of the Royal Society of Literature in 1962 and he died in 2009. Now we will begin with the poem, No Men Are Foreign. In this poem, James Kirkup states that we should not regard any person as a foreign person or any land as a strange land. The poem is an appeal for brotherhood, and the idea of the poem is that all men are equal, though they are separated by boundaries. There lies no difference between men of different nations. The difference is within one's heart. People are wearing different dresses, their food habits are different, their colors are different. Still, these differences are not of much significance. So now we begin with the poem, No Men Are Foreign. Remember, no men are strange, no countries foreign. Beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes. Like ours, the land our brothers walk upon is earth like this in which we all shall lie. They too, aware of sun and air and water, are fed by peaceful harvest, by war's long winter star. In the opening lines, the narrator, the poet says that we have to remember that no man, no human being is a stranger and no land, no country is a foreign land. All are equal. Though they are different in appearance, yet the heart is same. In the second line, the poem says, beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes. Now by beneath all uniforms, he means that this body is a uniform. Like we wear dresses, different types of dresses, uniforms. So this body is a uniform for the soul, for the heart. So beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes means under all human body, the same type of soul is there. The mere variation is in the food habits, the clothing sets, and no other difference is there. Then he says, like ours, the land our brothers walk upon is earth like this in which we all shall lie. Means our brothers, means the people of the other countries or the people living on this earth. They are like own brothers and they walk on the same land, on the earth. Like we walk on the earth, they also walk on the same earth. Same earth in which we all shall lie. And after death, the body is buried in the same way as it is buried over here, similarly it is buried all over the earth after death. Further he says, we all are the children of the same God. So we are all equal and are conscious of blessings of the sun, air and water. We are all blessed, means they too aware of sun and air and water, means they are also aware of sun, air that we breathe and the water we drink. We are all fed with the same thing. And we all in the same way are dependent on these three elements. Are fed with peaceful hours but war's long winter's strife. People in the neighbor countries are equally scared of war. And they also love peace as we do. We love peace, they also love peace. They also experience prosperity in times of peace and go through hardships, many hardships during war like we do. And in today's time, it is very true, like we all are going through the hardship of this coronavirus, COVID-19. So not only we Indians are going under this hardship, rather the whole of the world is suffering this, and it is a big terror. Similarly, all over the world, people are go through many hardships in the same situations, and everyone loves peace and prosperity. In further lines, the poet says, their hands are ours, and in their lines we read a labor not different from our own. Like we are having these hands, similarly they also have hands. They also work with their hands, we also do. And we read that their labors are also the same as we are. The labors of our place are doing the works from the hands. Similarly, the labors over there also, they also work in the same way. Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and strength that can be won by love. In every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. We should remember, they also sleep like we sleep. They also have the eyes that sleep and wake. We also have the eyes that sleep and wake. And everywhere, all over the world, the strength can be won by only love. Love is the thing, peace is the thing that can be the bonding between people all over the world. Means all men can be won by the virtue of love. And the common life led by people is same everywhere. That the basic essentials are same in every land. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispose, betray, condemn. Now, whenever we are asked to fight with other people within a land or outside our land, it is not that we are fighting with someone else, rather we are fighting with our own brothers. As no one is a stranger and no land is a foreign land, and we should not hate anyone. If we are hating someone else, it is not that we are hating others, we are hating our own selves. To hate our brothers, it is ourselves. In this line, he has clearly said, to hate our brothers, it is ourselves. That we are hating the humankind, and even we are humans, so we are hating our own selves. When we look down upon others, it is not actually we are looking down upon others. It is we are looking down upon ourselves. So, in this poem, in these lines, the poem, it is an appeal for unity against war and the use of weapons. Like in the next lines, he says, remember, we who take arms against each other, it is the human earth that we defile. Arms means, arms is the weapons. When we are fighting or there is a war against each other, we are destroying the human earth. We are destroying the Mother Earth on which we all are living. We are not destroying each other. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. And what we are doing, we are just destroying everything, the earth. Like when there is a war, the dust and the smoke that comes out of the weapons, the guns, what do? They just pollute the air, and that air is everywhere that we all are inhaling, and then it is polluting our own self. Therefore, the poet reminds us of the futility of the war and the significance of love. Remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange. Again, in the end, the poet ends the poem with the line that remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange, means the people of different countries may differ in complexion and clothing, but are in same mental, physical and emotional experiences. The poem is an effort to wipe away all sorts of hatred among people of the world. It emphasizes on the futility of war and weapons that only add pollution to innocence. So we should always remember that it is one Mother Earth where we are living, and we have to be one and fight against any big disaster that comes. And of course, we have to fight for this COVID-19 and be safe. Thank you.